Hello, I am Luis Nuño. I am a professor in the area of signal theory and communications at the Polytechnic University of Valencia in Spain. Now I'm going to explain the key signatures in music theory and the order of sharps and flats. The key signature is the set of accidentals in a major or natural minor scale. The order of sharps and flats refers to the appearance, the order of appearance of them in the formation of the scales. A tetrachord is a group of four notes at the beginning or the end of a scale, that is, degrees 1 to 4 or 5 to 8. We will start with C major scale, as well as its relative minor, A minor scale. The relative minor is always a minor third below the major key. These two keys have no accidental in their key signature. First of all, we will assign a Roman numeral to every note in both scales, and we will call them, as we can see in this table, tonic, supertonic, median, subdominant, dominant, superdominant or submedian, leading tone in the case of a major scale, or subtonic in the case of a natural minor scale. The last degree is the octave or tonic. We will use the same names for every scale. If we start with the C major scale, which notes are C, D, E, F, G, A, B, and C, and we want to obtain other major scales, one way is to sort out those notes by perfect fits. That is, we will write first note F, then C, G, D, A, E, B. In this sequence, the first note is the subdominant, the second one is the tonic, and the last one is the leading tone. So, following this process, we can include a new perfect fifth over the last note, B, which is F sharp, and this way we obtain a new major scale, which is G major. Remember that the second note is the tonic. We can go on with this process by adding other perfect fits on the right of this diagram. This way we obtain first the G major scale and then the D major scale. In all these cases, we always use the same seven names for the notes. The only difference is that, for example, in C major, all the notes are natural. In G major, we change F to F sharp, and in D major, we change F and C to F sharp and C sharp. This way, the order of appearance of sharps is exactly the same as the order of the notes in the C major scale when we sort them by perfect fifths. That is, F, C, G, D, A, E, B. So, if we have a key with two sharps, that is until C sharp, it means that this note is the leading tone. So, the key is D major. If we are in a key with six sharps, that is until E sharp, this note, E sharp, is the leading tone, and so the key is F sharp major. In the center area of the abacus, if we are in the C major, A minor keys, we find the order of sharps here, F, C, G, D, A, E, B. If we consider another major scale, for example, D major, which we have here, as well as its relative minor, B minor, in this case, we have two sharps, which are F and C, as we can see at the center area of the musical abacus. We can do the same process, but by including an additional note below F, a perfect fifth, that is note B flat. This way, we obtain the F major scale. Here, we have B flat instead of B natural. We can repeat the process by including another note below B flat, a perfect fifth. This way we obtain a new major scale, which is B flat major. In all cases, we use the same seven names for the notes of a scale, and the difference is that some of them may have a flat. So the order of appearance of flats is exactly the same as in the sequence of the notes of the major scale, but now in the opposite order, that is by perfect fourths, that is B, E, A, D, G, C, F. For example, if we have a key with three flats, that is until A flat, it means that the last but one note, that is E flat, is the tonic. So this is the E flat major scale. If we consider a key with seven flats, it means that the tonic is the last but one note, that is C flat, so C flat major scale. At the center area of the musical abacus, we can find the order of flats if we are in C major A minor scale, that is B, E, A, D, G, C, F. As an example, here we can see the E flat major scale as well as its relative minor, C minor. They contain three flats in their key signature, which are B, E, A. We can represent all the keys along with its accidentals. As we can see here, the keys with flats are F and other notes with flats, and the keys with sharps are natural notes except C and F and some notes with sharps. Here we can see that there are some enharmonic keys. So C flat major containing seven flats is enharmonic to B major containing five sharps. G flat major containing six flats is enharmonic to F sharp containing six sharps, and D flat major containing five flats is enharmonic to C sharp major containing seven sharps. So we can represent all the keys in the so-called cycle of fifths, as we can see here, and at the bottom part we have the enharmonic keys. Another way to connect the major scales is by tetrachords. We can divide a major scale into two tetrachords, for example C major. We can see that we can divide it into first tetrachord C, D, E, F, and then a whole step up the second tetrachord G, A, B, C. The intervallic structure of the two tetrachords is the same, whole tone, and half tone. So we can use the second tetrachord as the first tetrachord of a new scale, which is G major, which contains the F sharp. In the same way, we can include a tetrachord below C, thus obtaining the F major scale, which B flat, with B flat. If we try to do the same process with a minor scale, we cannot do it because now the two tetrachords have a different intervallic structure. First tetrachord is whole tone, half, whole, and the second one is half, whole, whole. So if we try to obtain a new minor scale starting with E, we need F sharp instead of F. Anyway, it is usual to divide every major and minor scale into two tetrachords, as we can see here, for a major scale, D major, and for a minor scale, as it is done in the musical abacus. As conclusions, the key signatures are obtained by sorting the notes of C major scale by perfect fifths, which leads us to the cycle of fifths. The order of sharps is F, C, G, D, A, E, B, that is following a sequence of perfect fifths, and the order of flats is similar but by perfect fourths, that is B, E, A, D, G, C, F. In any major or minor key, the same seven names are always used for the notes. The only difference is that some of them may be sharp or flat. The tetrachords can be used for connecting the major scales. The musical abacus includes the key signatures, the order of sharps and flats, and the tetrachords. You can find all the information on the webpage harmonicwheel.com. Thank you very much for your attention.